board games are cool again. That's partly because there are so many more options than just a million different versions of Monopoly and Cluedo. The modern wave of tabletop games mixes engaging themes with surprising and interesting ways to play, creating unforgettable experiences you can replay many times without it feeling the same. The best board games avoid the traps of leaving you bored between turns or at the mercy of random dice roll as the decider of your success or failure. They give you strategies to think about, social elements to take advantage of, or even just cool components to fiddle with. If you're going to get just one board game, you'll want one that you can replay a lot of times without it feeling repetitive and getting stale over time. Something with a very different feel every time you play. Stay with us until the end because you don't want to miss our number one pick as we count down the five best board games. And before we begin this list, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel for more informational list related content just like this one. And don't forget to ring the bell so you don't miss any new lists as we release them. And you can find a link to all the options on our list in the description down below. Now, let's get started. Number 5. Ticket to Ride, New York. Ticket to Ride is a series of games in which you collect colored cards, use those cards to connect different locations on a board, and get points for doing it. Simple. There are bigger versions of the game that cost more and play over a longer time. But we love this miniaturized version, which gives you all the tactics of the full game, but in a short, sharp, concentrated burst. On your turn, you'll mainly do one of two things: pick up two cards from the available pool of five to add to your hand, or take cards from your hand matching the color of spaces on the board, and put your little taxi pieces down to claim that route as your own. You need to claim routes because you each have secret cards that tell you two places on the board with a points value, and if you can connect them using continuous routes you've claimed, then you'll get the points. If you don't connect them, then you lose that many points. You also get points simply for claiming routes, and also for linking tourist spots on the board regardless of whether they're on your secret cards. It's a really basic setup, but the key thing is how small the board is and how few routes there are, and how quickly the game ends. You need to get in fast because with four players, the routes are taken so much more quickly than you think, and the path that you want to take might be totally cut off. Play moves fast as people rapidly take new cards or claim routes, so you can pile through a game in under half an hour, then immediately line up to play again if things don't go your way. Number 4. Pandemic. This game has been in the list since way before the current situation, but it's only become more appropriate. Pandemic is a game of trying to stop diseases outbreaking all over the earth, working together with everyone else. On your turn, you need to use your actions to move around locations, treating diseases, building research stations, and finding the cures that will win you the game. But with only four actions per turn, you won't be able to do very much of it on your own, and after each player's turn, more disease appears on the board. If too much appears in one city, it outbreaks to everywhere nearby, and you can only take so many outbreaks before you lose the game. So, you and other players must work together to plan ahead, triaging where the danger is now, and analyzing what's vulnerable in the future. Who can get to Beijing the fastest to treat the situation there? Madrid's at risk of an outbreak next turn, but focusing on that would delay your ability to cure one of the diseases by a whole round. So, what do you want to focus on? Each player also has an extra power that makes them good at specific tasks, so you need to make sure that you're using them effectively. Don't have your researcher treating disease cubes when you're the best at finding the cures, unless you really need them to. A clever tension is added by the card system at the heart of the game. To cure diseases for good, you need to collect sets of matching colored cards, except that these cards are also the fastest way to move around the board, and if you use them to travel, you can't use them to cure. So again, you're working out whether you need to spend a valuable card zipping across the board to prevent an outbreak or whether you can risk leaving it to someone else. But you know that more disease will come out in the meantime. And we haven't even mentioned the epidemic cards. Sprinkled throughout the deck you draw from, these instantly step up the danger, not only spreading the disease to a new location, but also guaranteeing that every location that currently has disease will get more of it. Cleverly, you can make the game harder or easier by adjusting how many epidemic cards you include. Pandemic is wildly popular, and that for good reason. It's a compelling and dynamic experience that gives you lots of opportunities to feel triumphant even before the game is won. The right move at the right time to help you avoid defeat feels like a win in and of itself. Being cooperative, kids can play along with adults without any penalty to their inexperience, since you can talk strategy together. And there are three expansions to add even more to the mix. We recommend On the Brink, which adds three variations to the game, plus new roles for players to be, and you can combine the variations in different ways if you want to make it really interesting. Number 3. JAIPUR. JAIPUR is made only for two players, and it pits you against each other perfectly by creating an almost prisoner's dilemma-like system where you must decide whether to go for speed or quality. It's a trading game. There are cards in the middle of the table you can pick up, and if you collect enough matching color cards, you can trade them for tokens with points values on. But how many matching cards should you collect before trading? Whoever trades a color first gets higher value tokens. But if you trade a larger number of cards in one go, you get special bonus tokens with big points of their own, on top of the regular tokens. So, can you afford to spend one more turn collecting another couple of cards and going for the big payout, or will your opponent nip in the first and leave you with the leftovers? Some colored tokens are worth much more than others too. So, do you both compete for the same high value stuff, or do you go for more of the low value cards your opponent is ignoring? Even seemingly easy ways to win can be tight decisions. There are only 5 cards in the middle of the table to take from at any time, and if 3 greens come out, you might think that it's a great bonus for you. But those 3 will be replaced with something as soon as you take them, and what if it's something more valuable that you leave open to the other players? It's beautifully designed and printed, and the box has a really pleasing custom inlay that keeps everything arranged perfectly. And it's cheap. Number 2. Photosynthesis. Take your place as Mother Nature, competing with other players to plant trees of your color in the best spots in the forest, where they'll absorb the lightest. Not only does the arboreal theme make this game look absolutely beautiful, the 3D trees will sucker anyone into playing. The fact that each player's trees are different shapes, as well as colors, helps colorblind people. It works logically with the rules, making learning to play so much easier. At the start of the game, you'll place 2 small trees in spaces near the edge of the hexagonal board, and you'll have a bank of more small trees, medium trees, and large trees ready for later in the game. You'll also place the sun token along 2 sides of the board. The sun's light beams in straight lines across the board from the token, and if your tree gets touched by it, you get light points, which you can spend to plant more trees or grow your existing ones. The problem? If your tree is behind someone else's, the sun won't reach it, so you'll get fewer light points that turn. The bigger the tree, the longer the shadow it casts. But the good news is that the sun moves partially around the board every turn, so suddenly your shaded trees are in the sun and others are in the dark. When the sun has gone all the way around the board 3 times, the game ends, 18 rounds total. At first, you can only plant seeds of new trees near your existing trees, but as your trees get bigger, you can spread out more broadly, and that's where things get crunchy. You're all competing for the same prime spaces, but your trees take several turns to grow, so you are able to predict what will be in light and what will be in shadow in 3 turns time. And you should keep a big tree around to cast shadows and cause your opponent's problems, or trade it in for the points you need to win the game. It's a game that offers lots of strategy and feeling of deep competition, but it's not one where you really come out thinking someone treated you cruelly or anything like that, because any plan takes several turns to pull off, so you could change your strategy and avoid the problem. And you can't help but love the pretty forest you build while playing. Number 1. Cosmic Encounter. We like to say that Cosmic Encounter is the board game equivalent to Mario Kart. Practice will make you better at it, but it's just enough wild stuff happens in each game that a beginner always has the chance of winning, which makes it great for both first-time players and veterans. The basic rules are pretty simple. Every turn, a player is randomly matched with another player, and the two must either fight or negotiate. They can invite other players to ally with them in the fight in exchange for rewards. The idea is to be the first to have 5 colonies on other players' planets, either by winning battles or negotiating well. It's a very easy set of rules to learn. The wrinkle is that every player has a unique alien power that totally breaks those rules. One alien wins battles if it loses them. One alien gets to take other players' discarded battle cards, becoming more powerful the more other users use their best cards. One can just invite itself to others' encounters as an ally even if they don't want it, racking up the rewards. Another wins the whole game if it loses all of its ships, meaning no one can tell whether you're going to try to win or intentionally lose any any given battle. Added to this are extra one-use cards you can have in your hand that break the rules even more, plus the way that the game encourages you to form alliances to stop players who are doing too well. It's a game that's guaranteed to get you laughing when everyone's best laid plans crumble. With 50 alien powers in the base game, the sheer scale of what can happen in Cosmic Encounter is why we love it so much. It's impossible to get bored of, yet is surprisingly easy to learn. I hope this countdown of the 5 best board games was informative and helpful. Don't forget to ring the bell so you don't miss any new lists as we release them, and you can find a link to all the options on our list in the description down below. Join us next time for another Top 10 Tech Countdown.